now you have the Philippine Reclamation Authority even saying that these projects, they were compliant with all the government requirements. But here's the question. It may be right, it may be legal, it may be legal and compliant, but was it right to begin with?
I'm not even admitting nor accepting their claim that this is legal. Because I talked to the mayor of Manila now, Mayor Lacuna, and she denies having any knowledge in the procedures followed. Sabi nga niya, hindi naman dumaan sa kanya yan. So, sino nag-aaproba? Kung sino na lang appointed official dyan, siya ang sumusuko sa temptation ng corruption, hindi tayo dapat pumayag. Diba? Public waters are public wealth to be enjoyed by every Filipino and not by anyone in particular.
Why are you so sure that corruption had a hand in these reclamation projects? Go ahead.
Because when I was mayor, I was being offered huge sums of money to approve the reclamation project. But I did not succumb, and I rejected the idea of covering up the bay with sand and rocks and materials and depriving the future generations to enjoy the Manila Bay, which I enjoyed as a young boy in Manila. Manila Bay should be saved from all of this.
But right now what we're looking at, Mr. Atienza, is just a suspension coming from the president. We still don't know the ultimate decision here, but let's go further. Do you think the president should permanently stop all reclamation projects in Manila Bay?
I would suggest that. No reclamation should be allowed anymore, as this will deprive the ordinary Filipino an opportunity to share in the God-given public waters that we used to enjoy. Kailangan itigil na yan. Kailangan yung Philippine Reclamation Authority should be abolished, and no reclamation should be even considered.
But what about the billions that will be lost due to the stoppage of the reclamation projects? Those who are supportive of it, that's what they're saying. The Philippines stand to lose billions. And not just with the stoppage of this, they're also saying FDIs will get affected. Your take on that?
On the economic side, sabi nila makikinabang daw ang Pilipinas. Sabi nila makikinabang daw ang mamamayan. Let me ask. Ang dami na reclamation project na natuloy. Yang kay Stonehill sa Manila, yang sa Parañaque, yang sa bandang Pasay. I ask the ordinary citizens, nakinabang ba kayo dyan? O nakinabang yung mayayaman? Sino nakapwesto ngayon? Dyan sa Mall of Asia, dyan sa Asiana, dyan sa portion ng MOA. Sino nakinabang? Nakinabang ba ang pangkaraniwang tao? Baha and squalor ang sindiraranas ng Pasay ngayon. Nabulok ang Pasay dahil sa reclamation project na lumusot.
At balik po tayo dito sa reclamation project sa Manila Bay. Sinasabi niyo po, Mayor, dapat kasuhan lahat ng kasangkot sa pagpayag sa reclamation projects na ito. Saan ho magsisimula? At sino po ultimately, kaduluduluhan po, ang responsable dito?
Alam niyo, maghihintay tayo sa bunga ng order ng ating Pangulo. Pero kung talagang walang bibidemanda, I will file a suit to test the waters para mabigyan ng pagkakataon yung mga kinaukulan, dumepensa kayo sa korte. But I will not hesitate to file a case myself in the Supreme Court because they even violated the Supreme Court order. Ang order ng Supreme Court during my environment secretaryship ay linisin ang tubig ng Manila Bay. Linisin para magamit ng pangaraniwang tao. Anong ginawa nila? Instead na linisin, nagtayo ng white sand beach. Spent billions of pesos for that white sand beach, which is useless. Now, tambakan ngayon ng basura yan. At ano ang ginawa nila? Nilinis ba ang tubig? Hindi. Tuloy-tuloy ang pagdaloy ng sewerage ng Metro Manila sa Manila Bay. The water has not been cleaned. Ang ginawa nila, binilisan nila ang mga reclamation project. Meaning, tatakpan na lang ng lupa yung problematic polluted, poisonous Manila Bay waters. Linisin natin yan, pakikinabangan ng buong Pilipinas yan.
You're saying you will not hesitate to file, although you will wait for the president's actions. If it comes to that, that you will have to file and test the waters, file cases against those responsible, whose names will be in that list? Who's the first one that you want to be charged?
I'm sure there are enough concerned Filipino environmentalists who are interestedly watching. Kung wala ngang mangyayari, I'm sure gagalaw ang taong bayan. And paggalaw ng taong bayan, kasama na po riyan si Lito Atienza.
Pero sino po ang una niyong gustong kasuhan?
Yung mga nag-aproba ng permiso. Who gave them the authority to approve? The mayor of Manila today denies knowing anything about it. I'm sure the other mayors in Metro Manila don't know anything about the reclamation. So sino? Philippine Reclamation Authority? Let them justify themselves. Let them defend themselves in court. But I will definitely pursue the issue. I am committed to protect the public waters of Manila Bay and the rest of the country. Yaman ng Pilipinas yan. Yaman ng bawat Pilipino yan. Hindi dapat pinakikinabangan lamang ng ilang tao at ng mga ilang opisyal na kumahagat sa tukso ng salapi.
Do you think ultimately that former President Rodrigo Roa Duterte should be charged as well?
I do not see the hand of President Duterte. I see the hand of the Philippine Reclamation Authority. Doon muna tayo mag-umpisa.
Is there turning back? I mean, now where you're at as a former DENR secretary, do you think there's still time? Do you think that there's still resources to turn back the hands of time? I mean, you talk to environmental experts and they're saying the damage has been done. It's going to take thousands of years to bring back the ecosystem, the biodiversity within the waters of Manila Bay. What are your thoughts on this?
You said it all, Carmina. You said it all. The damage has been done. It will continue to damage the environment. And reclamation is not the solution to our efforts to develop the potentials of the nation. The maintenance of what our natural beauty, of our natural environment, are the key to national progress. Kaya yung ginawa nila, although damaging, we should not continue now the destruction of the waters of the Philippines. We should not allow it. We must fight it. And we must abolish all the offices involved in the deterioration of our shorelines and our public waters. Yung Philippine Reclamation Authority should be reviewed. If I were a congressman today, I would file an immediate motion, an immediate measure to abolish this office, which seems to be the cause and the main reason for all of this illegal destruction of our natural wealth. Mm.
Talk to us about, you know, the requirement of having an ECC, that it's supposed to be that barrier to protect our resources in our country. But right now, the way it's going, it's like it's a transactional thing that's happening now between the country, that the office, and the clients, which they see these developers as. I mean, how do you even remedy that systemic problem?
Carmina, the arithmetic is very simple. To reclaim any portion of our Philippine waters, you spend about 5,000 pesos per square meter. Reclaiming Manila Bay, you spend about that much. And then when you develop a parcel of land, solid ground for real estate development use, you sell it for about 300 to 400 thousand pesos per square meter. So, ang daming pera ang ginagawa ng mga interested parties. And there's so much money for them to give around to officials who are willing to accept. Kaya, ang aking pakiusap sa mga kinaukulan, lahat ng mayors ng Metro Manila, huwag niyo ibigay ang pagkasira ng ating yaman na dapat ma-enjoy ng buong Pilipinas at ng mga henerasyon ng mga darating pa mga Pilipino. Do not succumb to the temptation. Believe me, you will even come out greater if you reject reclamation of any portion of our public waters, not only in Manila Bay, but in the whole of the nation. Ang kagandahan ng Pilipinas, nasa ating natural environment.
Many times during this conversation, Mr. Atienza, you mentioned future generations. Funnily enough, that's also what the developers are saying, that this this is because there's nowhere else to go when you look at the metro, and this is a development that's meant to serve the future generations. Same argument being used in different ways.
Meron ba kayo nakitang reclamation sa San Francisco Bay? Meron ba reclamation sa Hong Kong na masasabi ninyong katulad nitong mga reclamation natin? Meron ba reclamation sa ibang bansa na matino ang gobyerno? Dito lang nangyayari yan dahil pumapayag ang mga may hawak ng kapangyarihan. Kaya pinupun ako, ito hindi para sa akin, kundi para sa ating buong Pilipinas na hindi tayo dapat bumigay dito sa alok ng mga mayayamang investors, give them the right to reclaim as they will have new development, new economic opportunities, but in reality, they will make billions of pesos depriving us of our natural wealth. So, ito'y inaalisan ng pera ang Pilipino para magkamal ng billion-billion ang mga reclamation companies. Mm.
Again, I want you to put your head as a former DENR secretary. The task now of the current DENR secretary is massive. It's huge when it comes to the reclamation projects. I mean, talk to us about the amount of pressure that she may be feeling right now, and how she's going to tread these murky, dangerous waters.
This is a test of the competence, patriotic sense, the integrity of the present Department of Environment Secretary. Pag siya bumigay, kasama na siya. Pero babantayan natin. Naniniwala naman ako na tatayo ng matuwid ang ating DENR Secretary ngayon at hindi siya papayag sa mga pressures. I'm sure the President is now experiencing a lot of pressures himself with that decision to stop the reclamation project. Maraming makapangyarihang mga elemento ang will try to convince him to lift the embargo, to lift the ban. But I urge the President, Mr. President, this is an opportunity for greatness. This is an opportunity for you to show your real concern for the Filipinos. Reject all of these pressures, and we are supporting you.
Lito Atienza there, former mayor of the city of Manila, former secretary as well of the Department of Environment and Natural Resources. We appreciate you taking the time to talk to us this noon. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Carmina. Let's continue the struggle to save the country from all of this interested moneyed class out to make more money for themselves, not to develop the Philippines.
Really appreciate your time. Continue to take care. That was Lito Atienza, former mayor of the city of Manila, former secretary as well of the DENR.